Jensen. Let's go, Jensen.
Flash the microphone, get it fired
up. Oh, yeah. Let's show some intensity, boys. Wait, what is it?
Looks like we had a false start of some sort.
Huh?
And some sort of a false start. I don't know what.
Did the guy make the run before he hit the ball, or?
I don't know. Hit the rewind on the film. Let's get an instant replay.
Instant replay. It's an iPad. It's not too special. Oh, wait.
I did it again.
We did it again.
Guys, you can't take off before the kick. Runners are taking off before the kick. Referee says, hey, you can't do that.
We did it again.
Well, they touched it sideways. So if they wanted to be sneaky about it, the one with the referees to the referee's back, he could take off, but the one he's seeing in front of him has to stay back, but that's just cheating.
And they got called for it twice, and they did it again. They must have really wanted to do that play.
Yeah.
Nothing simpler would possibly ever do.
Part of the problem is a lot of our team hasn't played club soccer. They're all street players. So the whistle went off. Hey, let's go.
Really? I don't know that. I mean, the varsity team is pretty good. I would expect a few to play club.
Pelican throw in.
Yeah, the girls team was even more fun. Had a bunch of them that never played soccer before.
Oh boy. Varsity or JV?
JV.
Okay.
There was a whole group of refugees, like six of them on the team. It was like, can't pronounce their names, don't know who they are. They just did what they wanted.
Kick for the Falcons.
Get his way through a crowd and got lost. Nice. Oh, take it with you, there, buddy. Now that needed to a Jensen throw in. I thought that was passed to that guy. Must have been deflected.
Yeah, that was a fall. Didn't we?
Three kick for the Falcons. Conlon there to take the kick.
Is Conlon, the player, is he a sophomore?
Freshman.
Wow.
Jensen throw in.
Who is he? Who is this? Who's taking the throw?
Frieder. Frieder Howe or Hugh?
Yeah.
Number 16. To be honest, I don't know his last name. I think it's Hugh or Howe.
Yeah, I think it's Howe. Does he talk German?
No. I think he's British. He's a transfer student. British transfer student.
Corner kick for the Falcons. Taking the throw. Uh-oh. Throw in for Jennison. Schmidt taking the throw. Nope, handing it off.
Fair.
Looks like Howell taking the throw.
Thank you. Yeah, your dad said he was German.
Talks like he's British. He might be German.
Oh.
German.
Maybe the name's just German and he's British. Who knows?
Guess we'll never know till I ask him. That is number 8.
Baker taking the kick.
Number 8 would be Giuseppe. Is that Baker? Pretty sure.
Yep. Yeah, don't know their first names. Too many times first names are the same of multiple players, so I just use the last names.
And to be honest, most commentators for the games don't even say, like, who's taking the kick or the throw, or they just say subs sometimes.
Yeah, I've got a little different style than most of them. But I figured it.
And I prefer yours, to be honest.
Oh, thank you. I think it's nice for the parents and the players to hear their name once in a while, so if something happens where I can't.
Oh.
That was tough. Whoa, and he let it go.
Shoulder to shoulder, which isn't a foul, but I think if you take them off their feet, it is.
Well,
so.
Yeah, maybe not so much if they've come off their feet or not. It's just I thought I saw the arm go up and look more like a push, but. I had a post in my legacy too, so I don't know. I kicked it out for some reason. What are we doing? What are we doing? Just a friendly kick it out of play. That was nice. 20 taking the throw.
Logan taking the throw in for the Falcons. And a nice little generous effort giving it back to Jensen.
5. There's the ball. What's going on? Keeper's got it. Okay. He's got quite a leg, your keeper.
Yeah, he does. But also, so does Armand on the Kenwa team. I don't know his number, to be honest. He's 13, maybe? I don't know. He's got the ball. 8.
Coming in for the Falcons, number 25, Sinovich, and Jensen, number 5, Bosley.
And what we got going on? Throw in the far corner.
And I believe. Throw in.
Amar? I don't know. Number 8.
Now, how do you know all these people?
Oh, I see the numbers. Well, last game, I had one of the sheets and I.
Memorized them all.
I have a good memory. I didn't try to memorize them, but.
I just saw the number and there it stuck.
Well, I personally know Aldine. He played with my brother and I played with him sometimes.
Oh, nice.
And number 8, he's just one of those people you can't forget. He's.
I said that moment going. It's a hard place.
Number 8 is just somebody you can't forget. He's. he's a man. He looks like he's 30.
Yeah.
He's got a full beard. And then I know a few other players that I've played with on the varsity team.
Direct kick from Jensen. Substitute on the line for the Falcons is number 5. Ooh.
Number 8. That's down.
That's Strouser. 8. 9's the one you were talking of with the beard. Sakikic, I believe.
Is number 9 on right now? Maybe I can find him.
Should be far side.
I think he's the player that's down.
Oh, maybe.
It's either him or he got a clean shave.
It is number 9 that's down. Let's go and see his.
Number 9 is the person I'm talking about.
Go and see his beard from the distance.
Oh, yes.
Uh-oh, he hurt his baby.
And he shaved.
Yeah.
Slightly.
Cut a bunch of it off.
Slightly. Now it's like faded.
Trimmed, I guess.
Trimmed. It fades, which is.
You
don't see that often in beards. Am I talking too much? Is that bothering you? Or?
No, I'm fine.
Right.
I'll just ignore you if I have to say something.
Alright.
Phil can throw in. Set, taking the throw.
I think that was that again, but.
Yeah. looks like Seth's getting throw-in practice. Direct kick for Jennison. Snyder there to take the kick.
13 on the line and 20.
Osway and 20 is actually 26.
Nope, new guy, Gonzalo Tejador. What? Oh, and yellow, and he missed it.
Couple of substitutes coming in for Jemison, number 13, Hernandez Magoo, and number 20, Tito Lowe. Goal kick for Jemison.
Are they redoing it?
Yeah, the subs went off the field, yeah.
Jemison goal kick.
What grade you in?
I'm in ninth grade, right, sir. Freshman.
Yeah. I missed the sub opportunity. He kind of ran up to the line unexpectedly anyway. So you said you play soccer with Armand?
No, not Armand. I played with Eldine. I played with Emra. I played with
Jensen Thielen.
I believe just Eldine and Emra. I'm familiar with Colin because his dad was my coach.
No kidding.
Yeah. And I've played against him a few times, and every game I've scored a goal against him. I might have only been one game against him, but yeah, it's just one of those things.
You remember those things.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, nice.
I've only ever scored like 6 goals my whole life. Always played defender in midfield.
Oh, yeah. My son was a defender. Never scored a goal in his career until he started playing outside of college.
He played college?
Yeah.
Who did he play for?
Calvin.
Calvin.
Oh boy. 10, 14.
Joey 18, and 10, 12, Sam Smith. Joey and Sam Smith.
Coming in for Jennison, number 10, Shavy, 14, Schmidt, for the Falcons, number 12, Mishu, and 9, Zajdic.
Yeah, he played here at Kentwood, and then...
So what major did he go for?
Engineering.
Engineering minor?
I don't know that he had a minor.
Hmm.
I suppose he probably should have, but I have no idea what it was. Might have been philosophy.
Philosophy is like one of those things that everybody just takes as a minor. Unless I got something in mind.
Yeah.
Then.
Trick kick for Tennyson.
Alma and Kelvin at the time would have their defenders would come up and be strikers. Most times this is just a diversion to who's guarding this guy because nobody expected it. But he was making a nice breakaway run, had the ball, got tripped in the penalty area. Coach gave him the kick. He hit the post, it rocketed up into the sky about 20 feet.
The
ball.
The, what post?
The crossbar.
Crossbar.
Yeah, sorry. And then it dropped just behind the post and went into the out of play. And that was his only opportunity to score a goal. And then didn't want to do PKs and anything. 19-21.
Esteban Garcia Jr.
Coming in for the Falcons, number 21, Panetta, and number 19 for Jenison Garcia.
And taking the throw. Can't tell. Turn sideways.
Sam Smith.
14.
Sam Smith.
Alright.
Goal kick for the Falcons. Welch there to take the kick.
Mention his game or his name during the game. Yeah, they had a number of shootouts, but no, he didn't want to take any. In his younger days, he was a midfielder, and then the coach here at Kentwood needed him as a defender, and he ended up loving it.
Direct kick for Tennyson. Wildcat throw in.
Quick there, buddy.
Udi Umar.
Fun name. Did he touch it?
Yes.
Keeper did?
I'm pretty sure.
Corner kick for the Wildcats.
And we're going to give him a shot and a save. And who are we getting going for the corner?
We have...
20.
25. Yeah, 20.
Tina Dollar taking the corner kick.
Nice kick. And throw in for Jenison.
Throw in for Jenison. Vitaly taking the throw.
This 27's a good player for Falcons. Big, tall guy.
Offside.
Fast. Oh, hit
offside.
Oh!
He's way offside.
Offside call on the Falcons.
This big post didn't believe me. Ouch. two on the line. Velasquez. And I'm coming for the Falcons. Who are you? Oh, player down, stopping the clock.
In for the Falcons, number 13, Calabrese. And for the Wildcats, number 16, Howe. And 22, Velasquez. Jennison goal kick. Once again, Snyder there to take the kick.
Smith.
Throw in for Jennison. Schmidt taking the throw.
Thank you.
Schmidt taking the throw.
Well, to shine a little light, there's two Schmidts on the team, Sam. Oh, that was Joey.
For Jennison.
There's two Schmidts on the team?
Yes, six
and... Oh my
and
goodness, there it is. I didn't underline it.
Six and 14, the brothers. One's a freshman, one's a senior.
Yeah. Who scored that goal?
Joey, number 10, I think. 10?
Hey, I'm at the soccer game. Give me a second.
Coming in from Falcons, number 20, Logan.
No, Rudyard in the Upper Peninsula. My brother Dan liked to go up there to go hunting and fishing, and then sitting in that church, saw Lorraine and said, oh my goodness, she's so pretty, I want to meet her. Next thing you know, they got married, and then Dwayne married Mary, and Tim married Dorothy, and yeah.
Wow, so the Upper Peninsula.
Yep, they had 12 siblings.
Wow, how many girls?
Half of them. Maybe more. Let's see. There's Sid, Elvie, Jim, Rich. No, more girls. There was four guys, Rich,
and you just said,
Jim, Elvis,
this Upper Peninsula culture is not for me. I need a jump, girl.
Oh, hold on, I gotta focus here. Something's going on. I didn't stop the clock. Probably should have. No, he stopped it.
Madrid and Boston.
25 for the Falcons. All right. So you ran into a postman on a job site?
No, I'm writing my story.
Oh.
I'm telling about how.
Throw in for the Falcons. Coming in as a substitute, number 25, Sinovich. For the Wildcats, number 13, Hernandez Madrid, and number 5, Bosley.
So how do they, oh, that's right, you're done with your pig story.
What?
You're done with your pig story?
Kind of, but I'm rewriting a little bit at the beginning.
All right.
But I'm telling about how, like, four brothers married four sisters.
Three.
Three?
Yeah, Dan, Dwayne, and, or, yeah, Dan, Dwayne, and Tim. He died before he could get married. Oh! Yeah.
The other brothers were too lazy to do their own work and said, sure, I'll marry into that family.
Well, actually, Mary was going to take a job here at Keeler Brass, I believe it was.
Corner kick for the Falcons. Tomlin had never taken the kick.
And she had a place to stay. Dan asked Mom and Dad if she could room with us. And became a convenient thing for Dwayne. Dwayne had already moved out, but and he ended up marrying Mary, and then Tim would go up to visit Dan frequently, and there was Dorothy hanging around, and he ended up liking her, and they got married.
Okay. Well, cool. I'm going to incorporate that in my story.
All right. Your pig story or a different one?
Okay,
bye. See ya. That was my son Daniel that played soccer and never scored a goal.
Well, scoring is not everything about soccer. There's also...
Goal for the Falcons. Chez, number 27, with that goal.
Thank you. coming in, 22 on the line. He's going off.
Coming in for the Falcons, number two, Schmall. Direct kick for Jensen. Corner kick for the Wildcats.
Ten. It's
number 10. Ever get a goal scored on you with your keeper coming out all the time?
I don't think so. Might have been one, but to be completely honest, I don't think so.
Years ago, when my older son was playing, was one of the conference games, or no, district. Anyway, one of those. Offside?
I think the player was on the ground.
Direct kick from Jensen.
The keeper was out. About by the penalty mark. We had a direct kick from one of our defenders. He popped the ball high, hit the ground in front of the keeper, bounced over his head and into the goal.
No way.
Oh boy, talk to each other, guys. You take it.
Throw in for Jensen. Substitute coming in for the Wildcats is number 22, Velasquez. For the Falcons, 11, Cooper, 22, the win. Vitaly taking the throw. Sorry for the ball, boy. Jensen threw one by Kelly there.
Okay.
Goal kick for the Falcons.
Came in.
Number 17, Tucker, just came in from the Falcons. And Welch collecting the ball and taking the goal kick.
Well, the ball boy is still out in the field collecting the other ball.
kick for Jensen. Slider collected the ball and taking the kick. Direct kick for Jensen. Taking the throw for the Wildcats.
Well, that's trouble. If he gets rid of it. I didn't push him.
Maybe it should have thrown in.
It's on the side. Lost the ball. Whoops. Killing me.
Time to throw it.
1 minute.
1 minute remaining. Substitute coming in for the Falcons, number 14, is that?
Nope, I guess that's not coming in. Looks like it was 10. Thank you.
Little kick for Jensen. Direct kick for Jensen. Goal kick for the Falcons with 10 seconds left. Now 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.